Check. Check. Checkly check, check. Hey, guys and girls. This is Gordon Overkill with episode number 12 in our current Adom adventure with Spartacus, male, level 25, Mist Elven Duelist. And while the game loads, let me say, hi, Nisek. Welcome to today's stream. Here we are with Spartacus. Pretty strong for a Mist Elf, if I may say so. In the last episode, Spartacus successfully cleared a greater vault here in the Frost Giant Cave. But sadly, the loot was kind of underwhelming. Well, we're not done with this location yet. There is still the lesser vault here on the bottom level to be cleared. I'm wondering, why are we not wearing a necklace? We should, no, not death ray resistance. We should put on the rapid healing necklace for now, just to get back to full HP. Apart from that, I think we might just equip the Phial of Caladriel as our thrown weapon, just in case we need to put one of these guys out of action, like for example this Frost Giant Berserker. He's blinded. Now let's kill him. One hit and he's dead. Perfect. An Opal Ring and again the Phial of Caladriel. How do we want to kill this guy? I think we are resistant to cold. We got intrinsic cold resistance in the last episode, so just 9 points of damage. Not a big deal. So, there is yet another. Oh, we didn't equip the phial. Stupid. Let's do that now. We also get a scroll of darkness. Hi, One Silver Hand. Welcome to today's stream. Nice to see you. So, guys, let's hope that we maybe are a little bit more lucky with the loot here in the Lesser Vault than we were in the last episode. I think the chances are decent. Of course, we were not very lucky last time. Okay, here we are. Starting with the little frost white dragon hatchlings. They shouldn't be a problem. Since we are cold resistant now, their breath attack also does not do a lot of damage. We could wear a ring of fire to protect our gear. That's absolutely true, Nisek. And we are already wearing the ring of fire. Okay, fine. We already cared about that, apparently. But I really didn't remember that either. So these ordinary frost giants should not be a big problem still. Let's play that slowly. We saw him doing 14 points of damage with a hit. Red dragon scale mail, that would be an amazing finding if not we already had a red dragon scale armor and a very good one. Let's throw the file at the berserker and finish him off while he's blinded. Perfect. Water potion, turquoise potion, gold, and re-equip the file. Light scroll. Gold. Nothing apart from that. Okay, he hit us. He did hit us. So again, that's one of these berserkers. Let's blind him before we fight him. He drops an iron ration. We might eat that later. For now, let's first start with the outer parameter of the vault and finish the small fry. Maybe get some more nice loot. Nope, we don't want to bleed. tarnished amulet. That's a lot of loot here. A lot of unknown loot also. Not so far, nothing amazingly great. Pick up the money. We are pretty damn rich. Okay, 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 that's Hagar. Let's throw the file at him immediately. Okay, he still hits us. We punch him down pretty massively. Maybe one more hit. He hits us way too reliably, considering that he's blinded, but down he goes. Nisek, you're absolutely right. The file is working more consistently than the glove slap. I think the file of Galadriel is a pretty great item, especially for fighting humanoid enemies. Just for fighting humanoid enemies. But I also think that was pretty impressive. Let's throw them. Only thing annoying is that you always have to manually reload it. 2 points of damage, we don't mind. Once again, the goal for this episode is to finish the Frost Giant Cave, which we are just doing, and afterwards maybe do one or two of the random dungeons. I think we need a bit more power. We cannot go for the Tower of Eternal Flames instantly. We need a bit more loot, bit more experience. I would like to have around 200 HP at least before we go for the fight against the ancient Chaos Worms. So I hope that we can do that in this episode. So we're done with the Lesser Vault here. Let's see what the rest of the level has to offer. At least one more Frost Giant Berserker. The great thing about the file is it also works against some really tough enemies, like, for example, Nuragvan. Keeping Nuragvan blinded all the time is super, super handy. Okay, that's an ordinary dragon. I think we can melee it. Yes, we can. White gauntlets, we don't need. Trap detection, we take, and we also take the gold. I'm not exactly sure if we really need the gold, but well, if we can pick it up. Greedy little mist elf that we are. I think we just do it. So, we're done with this level. So now, quickly back up to the surface and let's search for a nice random dungeon to loot. Let's finish off this guy. Ice elemental, we don't really care. Hi, Raudo Testament. Nice to see you. Welcome to today's stream. You didn't miss a lot. We just finished the bottom level and killed Hagar, the Frost Giant Jarl. So we quickly go back here, but before we do that, let's swap our body armor back to the ancient mummy wrapping, just so we are immune to the cold damage. And let's quickly rush through this level. We are still invisible, that's perfect. Yes, Raudo, we did clear the Greater Vault. Sadly, we did not get any decent loot from it. All the items were pretty underwhelming, but well, at least we are. I think we leveled up 3 times, which is, of course, a nice thing. Well, we don't want all of them to become hostile. We just go through here. Ignoring. Caring too much? Oh, we're getting hungry. Okay, I see. We better eat a Stomophilium. So, fine. Do we take damage? Yeah, we take damage. Let's quickly swap the helmet to the water-breathing helmet. It's definitely worth. We take a little damage from the impure metal, but well, I don't think that we really mind. We just go through here. Swap helmets now. Back to the adamantium cap. We are a little low on HP. Oh, come on, but the Berserker Prince attacks us. Okay. The Berserker Prince. Let's take him seriously. He's blinded. That's good. And now kill him. So we just sneak past these guys. Now that the prince is dead, that's definitely good things. Oh, come on, who attacks us? Who does such mean things to poor little Spartacus? Sneak through this level. And we could kill the monsters in the prison, but maybe we do that later. Oh, we just lost our adamantium cap. Happens. If it's so windy, I guess you just cannot change that. Okay, now we lost our weapon. And let's see what the Frost Queen gives us as a reward. Welcome back, mortal. Hagar is dead? Very well. I am indebted to you. Take this as a reward. Additionally, you feel blessed in a very special way. Additionally, some items appear in front of you. Now you could do me another favor. Get rid of that chaotic wormling in the parlor, that diplomat. Maybe we'll do that later, but for now, let's take these four potions of cure corruption. That's the main reason why we came here. Almost back at full HP now. I think we leave the chaos diplomat alive for now. It's a bit too risky since we are just a melee character. We don't want to melee him. If we had a chance to kill him with spells from a distance, that would be a different story, but we have not. We could quickly clear the prison, though. I think, why not? Let's do that. Do we have a wand of knocking? Yes. Okay, it was cursed, so maybe we just locked the door. Let's kick it. And see which monsters await us here in the prison. We start from the very outside. One silver hand? Yes, I would love to find a decent artifact weapon. That would be so good, because at the moment, in terms of weapons, we are a bit under-equipped. Oh, wall beast. I would prefer not to fight a wall beast. Do we have a wand of dog creation? I think they can paralyze us, and I don't want that to happen. Let's create a door over here and ignore the wall beast. Literacy check we don't need. Okay, nothing so far. It's just a couple of orcs. Oh, we're getting hungry again. Stomophilia. Good. It's another war beast. Let's lock it in again, just to be safe. Here we have a quickling lord if he dropped a corpse. Nah, sadly not. Once the event, you're right. We were supposed to eat. I forget that way too often. Just imagine this. This ancient elven being of mystical powers walking through the prison and just kicking in all the doors. That's the way it's handled by a 5,000-year-old ancient being. Kick the door. And this door too. No, first kill the bat, then kick the door. So, we're done here. That was definitely not worth the effort. Oh, do I have any more heavy metal recommendations? You saw Metallica live last week. If you like Metallica, then maybe I could recommend you a nice old-school American thrash metal band. And there is one band that I would very much recommend, which is called Flotsam and Jetsam. Absolutely check out Flotsam and Jetsam. I will write it in chat. And maybe start with the album, what's it called? No Place for Disgrace? I think that's how it was called. That's a good... just start with the first two albums by Flotsam. Totally amazing band. Melodic vocals, super great heavy riffing. If you like Metallica, there is a very good chance you will also like the Flots. That sounds more like a German fairy tale. Ah, no, that's actually it's an old band from the 80s. And they have got an amazing guitar player, one of the best vocalists in thrash metal at all. And generally just a bunch of totally overwhelming songs. Until today, amazing live band. Absolutely recommend them. Maybe add a music channel to the Discord. I think there is a music channel. I just don't use it often enough. I can try to remember. Oh, come on. Don't tag me, asshole. Let's also kill this guy. Just because. I absolutely like power metal, but mainly the power metal from the mid to late 80s, which was a bit heavier than many of the modern power metal bands. I'm thinking of bands like Jack Panzer, Leech Lord, Overlord, or also very old Halloween, or other German bands like Adlane, or Storm, which that's the kind of power metal I absolutely love. Also some more modern, more melodic bands, but yeah, generally I think I definitely like power metal very much, yeah. Blind Guardian, totally. Oh, that's one of the saddest things that happened to me in the last weeks and months. At November 19th and 20th, we will play our first concerts since a long while with Messerschmitt, with my main band. And on the very same weekend, there will be the Keep It True Rising Festival in southern Germany, which has a headliner gig by Blind Guardian, playing a special old-school set, I think just from their first four or five albums, which is so great. I would have loved to visit this concert, and it has to be on the very day when we play ourselves at the other end of Germany. Super sad. But yeah, especially the first five Blind Guardian albums, I absolutely love them. Totally great. Yep, Flotsam and Jetsam is the chapter of is a chapter in the Lord of the Rings. You are absolutely right, Tokrat. By the way, Simuel and Tokrat, welcome to today's stream. Nice to see you. We are now done with our frost giant endeavors, for the moment at least. So I think the next point on our plan is we already did this one. This was the Antediluvian dungeon, but let's see if we can find more of these random dungeons. This one we already did it, the Moldy dungeon. Let's check the second level. Have we already done that too? Yes, seems like we're already done here. Are there any metal songs that would be good for a beginner to learn to play? You learned Breaking the Law by Judas Priest and looking for another song to learn. So I think you're learning the guitar, is that right, One Silver Hand? Or which instrument are you learning? I think one of the first songs that I learned on the guitar is called Trust in the Fire by the German heavy metal band Stormwitch. I could absolutely recommend that. It's relatively easy to play and it teaches you a couple of very cool techniques, and it's a fantastic song. Generally, check out Stormwitch, it's an amazing band. Okay, we haven't done this yet, the Ancient Dungeon. I will write the song in the chat again, by the way. It's Storm Witch, Trust in the Fire. That's one I absolutely love to play. Oh, Fire Giants. Let's see how they do against Spartacus. Ouch. It's great that you learn the guitar. I think that's a fantastic hobby. I personally absolutely love it. They do some damage. Let's do that in normal mode. We don't want to get hit all that often. Hello? What's going on here? These fire giants. They hit us all the time. I see the reason. We are burdened. We don't want to be burdened. Suhamati, I actually play in a thrash metal band and a heavy metal band, but I don't advertise that regularly on stream. Indeed, I think at the second but last Dungeon Crawl Stone Soup tournament, I played one speed run where I didn't want to do commentary, so I played a 7-inch single by my heavy metal band Atom Smasher in the background. But usually, I don't really do that. Wait a second. I just quickly have to drop some stuff before we continue here. Let's just go over here. Swap the armor. Also, we are still wearing the wrong armor. Concentration, Mr. Overkill. Concentration. So that makes our armor class look a lot better already. And we have to drop some stuff like all these heavy armors that we don't really need. That's enough. That gives us back our duelist superpowers. With Atom Smasher, we officially released just one 7-inch single so far, and with Messerschmitt, the speed thrash metal band, we released two albums and an EP. That's pretty much all the official releases we did. Okay, that looks a lot better. Now we don't get hit every single turn. By the way, I told you it was kind of sad that we couldn't that we played our concerts on the same date with Blind Guardian in Würzburg. Still, it's going to be a pretty cool concert. I don't know if anybody of you is into thrash metal, but for example, on the very day when Blind Guardian play in Würzburg, we will play together with Destruction, the legendary German thrash metal band, which is kind of cool. So let's max athletics. Let's now go for swimming. I don't want to take that much damage when we fall in the water. Stop doing damage, you damn fire giants. Ouch, that hurt. I said stop doing damage, not do even more damage. Okay, and we're done with these fire giants. Can I find us on YouTube? Yes, you can. Atom Smasher is actually not a very commercial band. We don't have a homepage or anything like that. And for the first 11 years of the band's existence, we did not release any songs officially. We just recorded them and sent them to our friends just for us. But you can find on the channel new wave of traditional heavy metal albums. NWOTHM albums. There you can find the Atom Smasher 7-inch. If you look for, wait a second, Atom Smasher, the Age of Ice. That's the title of the 7-inch, and the Messerschmitt albums are called Messerschmitt. Our current album is called Consumed by Fire. And the first album was called No Dread to Kill. So if you search for that on YouTube, you should find it. But it's just underground bands. It's yeah, also some live recordings with Messerschmitt. With Messerschmitt, we play live from time to time. And if you want to see me play the bass on stage, you can take a look at it. Nothing very professional. These live recordings is just guys filming from the audience. I think it's pretty cool that you are so many of you are interested in hard rock and heavy metal music, since that's actually my greatest passion. I spend a big amount of my free time listening to music, writing music, and all of that. You need inspiration for your work days. I can absolutely understand that. It's, having something inspiring before you go to work, I think that can change the whole day. So, first level is done. We have to take a little bit care because I'm pretty much playing on autopilot at the moment, and I hope I won't do anything really, really stupid. But at the moment, okay. This dungeon does not appear to be too difficult for us. Here we have a forge, but Spartacus is not a blacksmith. Is that a scalpel? We don't need that. Another room full of giants, this time stone giant lords, so let's be a little bit careful. We know stone giant lords hit like a truck when they crit. I'm a little bit disappointed of the experience we get from them. I wanted more. Anyways, at least they're dead. And well, and just in case, I know there are a couple of Dutch viewers on the Greater Clawbuck, not so nice. Ignores our armor. Let's fireball it. Didn't kill it. Let's kill it with another offensive thingy that we do not have. Quantum destruction, rather not. Trap detonation. Yum 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 yum. Let's go to coward mode and just hit it once. Okay, that worked. We are pretty fast, you're right, that reduces experience. But well, we're still at a decent experience level at the moment. Let's just drink the potion of boost appearance. There is no need to carry it around. What did I want to say? Ah, yeah. Since I know there are a couple of Dutch viewers, I will be at a very cool little festival in near Amsterdam. Not this weekend, but next weekend. It's called the Heavy Metal Maniacs Festival, and I could very much recommend that to every fan of traditional heavy metal. Light crossbow. Let's pick that up, just in case we need to shoot an arrow. Frog Nico! Hi, welcome to today's stream. Nice to see you. Eat this orc. Kill this lightning lizard. Oh, I get a lightning lizard corpse. Ah, oh, God. We get lightning lizard corpses, giant slug corpses, all the immunities we already have. Nice to always see some ADOM action. I'm glad you enjoy it, Frog Nico. Oh, and we've got a scroll shop here. Let's take a closer look at these scrolls. We have a lot of money, so everything that's useful, we might just consider buying it. Charging, we want that. Melee damage is nice. IBM guild manual, nope. Or repair, maybe. Treasure creation, nope. Charging, identify, luck. Item detection, monster detection, identify, repair, great identify, luck, and repair. These are the scrolls we might need. Let's just drop them here. But how much are they all together? 25,000, let's just buy them. Yeah, we just buy that. Finally a shop, Nisek, you're right. Just a scroll shop, if I may say so. Just. There are other shops that we would prefer to see, like a weapon shop with an amazing artifact weapon that we're looking forward to find since a long time now. I think over there is a secret door. Yep. Here are the downstairs. These are undead, mainly ghouls. We're not afraid of ghouls. We can just... I don't think they will be able to hit us with 52 dodge value. It's just an ordinary cut of stuff, I think. It looks normal. It's 40 stones. So far, this dungeon actually looks relatively easy. Let's see if it stays like that. But well, there's always a chance that we get a nice shop or anything of that kind. Or a random whatever weapon, one-handed weapon of penetration. Which we would absolutely take. One silver hand, I think we will shoot all of our arrows at the Ancient Chaos Worm. We trained bows a little bit. We've got it at level 3, which is actually pretty amazing for a duelist. But there is a very decent chance we have to kill it in melee. And that's the very reason why I want to level up a little more before we go to the Tower of Eternal Flames. We just don't have the means to kill the worm from a safe distance like we normally prefer to do. Let's go further down. The stuff of padding water has Y on the tip. Yes, we might need that for the tomb of the High Kings. We still did not get the Ring of the High Kings, which is a little bit sad. But well, not much we can do at the moment. Just lack the means of crossing the water. We still don't have a wand of. We do have a wand of code, so we could now build an ice bridge if we wanted to. But question is, I think the Ring of the High Kings is ordinary metal, isn't it? Isn't it made of iron? So can we even use it? I'm really not sure if we need to do the Tomb of the High Kings. Yeah, we want the ring, of course, but okay, yeah. I think we absolutely want the ring. So we don't have to mess around with the Eternal Guardian. Yeah, absolutely true. We want the ring. We have to do that. I think we do that very soon. And indeed, we can wear one ring made of iron. That's an ordinary doppelganger, I hope. Yes, it is. We can wear one ring made of iron, and maybe the Ring of the High King is the best choice because it also gives us pretty decent boosts to our defensive stats to, I think, 3 points of protection and 2 points of dodge or so. Yes, I have killed Eternal Guardians in the past, and I also tricked them in past runs, I think. Maybe we will do that again at one point. But I also have to say, there were times when I was a little better at the game than I am at the moment. I'm slowly getting back into it. This is our third good run this year. We already got 2 wins, and I think if we win this run, we might probably slowly start going for challenges again, which is pretty exciting. Stone wand, okay, nice. Boost learning, we just drink that. Because why not? Here we have a stone spear. Nope, thanks. Okay, this guy wants to rust our equipment, so we better kill him and then eat the ogre afterwards. Quickling. Okay, we've got the quickling corner. That's quickling royalty. That's good. Drop a corpse. Sadly, no corpse. It was a quickling king. Would have been amazing if it had dropped a corpse because that would have permanently increased our speed, but you cannot have it all, I guess. And since there is a giant rust monster on this level and quickling royalty, so I think the danger level is slowly increasing again. I don't mind that. I want to kill strong enemies. They give more experience, after all. And just keep eating these corpses because we are invisible all the time. The room is very humid. Okay, I'm not sure what the humid room actually did. Statue. It resembles a tall human wearing a heavy coat with a peaked cap on its head, bearing eagle and skull-shaped insignia unknown to you. You almost feel his cold stare probing deep into you. An inscription at the bottom reads, Max Otto von Stierlitz. That sounds like a very traditional German name. Max Otto von Stierlitz. Anybody got an idea what Max Otto von Stierlitz can do for us? If so, let me know in the chat. Okay, the monsters are fighting here. We help our ice blizzard brother. Yet another forge. Okay, the statue is a reference to the 17 Monuments of Spring, a Soviet series. Never heard of that. Grants temporary cold immunity if we wait on it. But just temporary. That would have been worth if we went there before the Ice Queen Palace or something like that. But at the moment, I don't think we need it. Not worth. Okay, yeah, of course we get cold breathed a second after I say we don't need it. Hi, Corin! Welcome to today's stream. Nice to see you. We are just finishing a random dungeon after doing the bottom level of the Frost Giant Cave. So far, no amazing loot in this episode, but we are void. We could just wait here. So we wait here. You feel cozy, so we are immune to cold for a short while. And this seems to be a mixed lesser vault. Mixed lesser vaults, kinda dangerous. Okay, let's wait for these guys. Fight them one at a time. Okay, he hit us too. We need to finish the corruptors first, and hopefully also the werewolf lord. From the damage, I kinda think that the werewolf lord does not count as a humanoid. Otherwise, we would have done more damage to him. Just on part for the fun time. Just on time for the fun part. Yeah, I think so. Frost Giant Jarl. We fight him slowly. If he crits, we need to be very careful. But luckily, he did not do that. Oh no, we just hit a Karmic Lizard. We hit a Karmic Lizard, and down there we have a ordinary doppelganger. Okay, Karmic Lizard, that means we maybe better let's read a scroll of identify first and then read a scroll of luck just to get rid of the negative effect. Let's identify our stuff, and now scrolls of luck. We have got two of them. Let's bless them. And read a blessed scroll of luck. You feel less unlucky? Okay, let's read another one. You feel lucky. Okay, that's feeling lucky. That sounds decent. Were we cursed? Okay, maybe we were. We could, by the way, we could try to get our bow skill maybe one level higher. We should be able to do that. Karmic Lizard dooms you with just a single hit, but we should not be doomed anymore now. I think we should be relatively fine. Less unlucky, he said, and then he said we were lucky, so I'm pretty sure we're not. We're definitely not doomed anymore, and probably not even cursed anymore. I think Scroll of Luck gets rid of that. We can have a close look at how we do in these fights. That's a Master Lich. That's actually pretty dangerous. Frost Giant Jarl. Kill it. Got it. Some source of insight. I think we do. The Master Lich cannot Death Ray, I think, can it? I don't want to risk it. Death Ray resistance and then fight. Oh, he healed. Severely damaged, and we killed the Master Lich. That's excellent. Swap back to maybe the Ankh, just for a little extra luck in case we need it. I think we do have a couple potions of insight. We will try that when we're done here. Okay, that's a master mimic. Let's shoot this karmic lizard. We could just shoot them all, I think. At least as long as they're not a melee. Blink dog, kill that. There was another comic lizard, but this time we played it a bit smarter and we didn't melee it. Can we outrun this guy? Probably not. Okay, we cannot outrun him. We better swap to the free action amulet. And then normal mode. Okay, he does damage, he does damage, he does damage. Let's play that safe. Let's recharge our wand of fireballs. Here it is. Where do we have boost? We don't have boost. Let's read the scroll of charging. I'm almost sure we bought a couple of these. Yep. Read that on the scroll of fireballs. The file works just against humanoid enemies, Nisek. It does not work against the mimic. We will fireball it. Oh, that was a critical hit. Nice. And I think we destroy it. We hit the master mimic and kill it. So let's go back to the Ankh. No, we did not kill it, but almost. And I'm almost sure now we get it. Fireball. Bam. Come on, fireball. Where are you? Yes, we killed the master mimic. Excellent. A master mimic, I respect them. As you could see, I absolutely respect them. This rope is just an ordinary rope, yes. There is a necklace on the ground. Yeah, but it was a brass necklace, I think, Corrin. It was a brass necklace. That's always useless. Cure poison. Splendid necklace and the arrows. A higher metal longsword and arrows. Let's eat the ration and the lizard. Okay, we're done here. What do we have in there? A unicorn and I think nothing super deadly. But our longbow of accuracy got destroyed. That's super annoying. Let's... Oh, luckily we've got another one. Okay, that's nice. Oh, the cat fights the giant. I like that. They can keep fighting. Giant, kill the cat, please. Meanwhile, we try to kill the unicorn. The cat is dead. Perfect. And the cat lord did not get any stronger from it. Yeah, yeah. This cat pretty much destroyed itself. It started a fight with a giant. Well, if I were a cat, I would not start fights with giants, I think. You don't need to be the smartest guy on earth to think that this is a bad idea if you're a cat. Okay, we kill this one though. We really have to take good care once we meet the cat lord. Berserker King. I'd like to fight him 1v1. Good, get him. See what they dropped. Monster detection. Arrow. I will try not to fight the Cat Lord at all, Suomati. I will try to avoid him, but I'm not sure if we will be able to do that. It's gonna be a challenge. Challenge much bigger than the last times we met him, where he just gave us the ring. Quarrels, eat the bad corpse. I think there must be some... Ah yeah, yet another whole new room. Going to all the trouble of avoiding kitty cats just to kill the cat lot. Frog Nico, we already killed a couple of cats in this run, so no chance to do the greater doppelganger. Okay. We do have... Wait, let's swap rings. Ring of Fire, go away. Mental Stability, here you go. Thick Gauntlets. Nope, these are shitty thick Gauntlets. Identify, we take that. Yeah, he sees invisible, that's right. I don't know how high his speed is. As far as I know, this depends on the number of cats you have killed in the game. So, if you kill just two cats, he will not be super strong, but we killed more than two cats. It's probably not so good. But we will see. Got the greater doppelganger, perfect. What did these guys drop? High metal rapier. It's broadsword. Is that higher metal? No, it's not, I think. It's ordinary metal girdle. Nope, nope, nope. But we take the gloves. Is there anything else in this lesser vault? Yes. Here is yet another room. And there is a fire giant king in there, and we surely don't want to fight him in a group. Ouch, that hurt. That hurt too. Now he's dead. Good. He is super duper fast, that's true. And without 7 league boots, it will be extremely hard to outrun him. The Cat Lord. Yeah, I can already promise you, the Cat Lord level will be a very big challenge for Spartacus. And maybe, I think we will be able to do it. I hope we will. Ouch! He threw his rock at us. Let's read a scroll of charging on our Wand of Cold. And zap him. Got the Fire Giant King, very nice. He dropped metal boots, a higher metal short sword. That's some nice stuff. And my goal against the Cat Lord will be to hopefully never see him in person. If he doesn't start right next to us, we might be able to avoid him entirely, and I hope we will be. Of course, he will give us a lot of experience if we were able to kill him, but I'm just not sure if we can. Tower shield, too heavy, I think. Don't really need that. Homunculus Corps, nope. Oh, he did damage. It was 11,000 points. Was it a Crystal Golem? Lawful Altar, I see. Wait for these guys. Ha! You are... Okay, literacy check. We are neutral, that's excellent. Is that excellent? Wait a second. Wait a second, weren't we lawful earlier? No, we were not lawful. We were neutral all the way, weren't we? Ah, God, luckily we were neutral. Whew. Kind of glad about that. Drop items of unknown status. Pick it all up. Do we have unblessed water? Three unholy waters. We can drop these two. Now it's holy water. Perfect. Neutral whole game. Okay, that's very good. Ah. Let's just sacrifice a lot of gold so we are not cursed anymore in case we were. Like 30,000 gold. Balance seems to be very close to you. Okay, we were not doomed. That's good to know. And that definitely means we've got a prayer or two left now. Swap to the rapid healing amulet, by the way. I don't want to walk around injured. So, down to the next level. Let's go. It's actually a pretty deep dungeon. That's nice. Especially this vault gave us a lot of loot. Like that. Close 40. That's the red cross. We don't want to eat that. Climb downwards. What do we have here? Nothing worth mentioning. Wand of ball lightning, though. Why not? There's even one more level downwards from here on. Monster detection, we take that. Goblin, we eat that. We are neutral equal by now. That's not bad. Don't need this iron two-handed sword. Catlord in this game will go like Catlord with thug glasses. I think so too, Corrin. I think so too. But well, it's gonna be intense. I like intense. And who knows how strong Spartacus will be at that point. I am all the way just waiting for that power boost at that point when we finally get... Oh, come on, stop that. When we finally get a very good artifact weapon. And we killed the Karmic Dragon. Excellent. What does he drop? Holy Symbol, Curved Wand, Water Potion, some gold. Are we poison resistant? Now we are. I'm pretty sure we were already poison resistant. Guys spawned here, and so many giants. Poisoned by the Slayer, but he drops the potion of ultra healing. Thanks a lot. We are pretty poisoned. He this go down? Yet again, no vault or anything of that kind. But it's still not the bottom level. We have found ourselves a very deep dungeon here. It was hard to predict because I always forget the names of the random dungeons. Let's read the Scroll of Light if we have one. Oops, sorry. Let's use the File of Galadriel. Perfect. There's another karmic dragon. Come on, let's get it. And we got him. Ring of Ginny summoning! That's our second wish, guys. Thank you very much, Mr. Karmic Dragon. I knew it was worth coming down here. What's that? That's probably our seven league boots. Or a girdle of giant strength or anything like that. That's super great. We've got ourselves a wish, guys. Seven league boots would be an amazing wish, of course. But so would be Girdle of Giant Strength. We can think about that. I don't think we will summon the Ginny in this very episode. We will keep the ring for at least one more episode so we can think a little what would be the best thing to wish for. But that's super excellent. Oh yeah. Wait, there must be a secret door somewhere. I don't think there is. This is the end. Not here, so maybe down there. We have a Ring of Ginny summoning! Oh yeah! Here is the secret door. I knew it must be there. So, and down to the next level. Yeah, I was almost thinking, was it really worth getting down here, or was it not? I don't know. So far, no overwhelming loot, just a little bit of experience, and then we got ourselves a wish. That's so nice. Absolutely great. Tenth level already. Wow, it goes deeper and deeper. And even deeper than this. Can it be much more than 10 levels? I'm not sure. Already playing for an hour, but well, let's do it a little longer. I think we just got on a lucky streak, maybe. Oh, whoa. Hello, Mr. Shadowworm. We don't want to melee the worm. And we don't want to melee the Moloch. Do we have Dragon Slayers? Let's quickly check that. Dragon Slaying Ammunition. Missiles of Dragon Slaying. Rusty Quarrels. Ah, they're rusty. That kind of sucks. 17 Arrows of Dragon Slaying. That's what we were looking for. 17 Arrows of Dragon Slaying. Let's equip that. And show this Shadowworm how this game is played. Bye-bye, Mr. Shadowworm. Do we have Humanoid Slaying Arrows? We do. Let's use these against the Moloch. Need to kill this guy first. And now shoot the Moloch. Nice. Shoot. Shoot. And one more. Oh no, we missed the last one. Any more Humanoid Slayers? Apparently not. We can just run around him. Pick up the Slayers from here. Oh no. Now shoot. Yes! And we've got the Moloch. Perfect. Pick up the Dragon Slayer, the Potential Learning, the Power Scrolls. There we have another Humanoid Slayer. Don't want to waste a single one of these. But we are already at a danger level here, where we meet dangerous enemies. Let's keep that in mind. With a Moloch and a Shadow Worm on one level. Who knows if that's even the maximum danger level that can spawn here. Maybe there are even stronger monsters waiting for us. Wait, there's some quarrels. Ancient Minotaur corpse. I think eating ancient Minotaurs is not a good idea, if I remember that correctly. Let's check if there is a secret door somewhere over here. Nope, there is none. So maybe that's all for this part of the dungeon. Let's go down to the next level. Stone Giant Lord. I still love the damage we are doing against these humanoid enemies. It's insane. Especially considering that we're not even having the best weapon in the game. It's still a big punch. It's a decent weapon, but not the super weapon that everybody's looking forward to find. This is an Eternium Flail? If that's penetration, I always think if that's penetration or devastation. Okay, come on, kill this guy. We're also very close to leveling up again. Let's check this first. Okay, both lead to the same room. At least no dead end where we would have to backtrack. Yet another undead room with relatively weak undead. Ghosts, wraiths, and ghouls. No ghosts, shadows, and ghouls. But that was no problem at all. Here are the downstairs. Again, we're still not at the bottom. Go down to level 12. Can't be much more. Let's ignore this cat for now. Wait a second. Maybe let's lure this vortex over to the cat and let it explode. Oh, the cat survived. That's a little bit sad. It's a fireproof lion. Damn you, fireproof lion. These guys tend to drop Eternium stuff. Eternium cap, I think. Let's check. That's probably better than ours. Plus 6 Eternium cap. That's an upgrade. Nice. Finally, we break through the 30 protection value mark. What kind of a dragon are you? A karmic dragon? We know that killing karmic dragons can be a very good idea. Sometimes they drop Ginny rings. Maybe again. Okay, that would be very random if it dropped a Ginny ring again, but we have to give it a try. Come on, kill it. Uncursing Scrolls, Spellbook of Farsight. Well, Spellbook of Farsight is a little sad, but I'm not sure if we would ever have learned it. So I think that's fine. Got a couple of nice utility items from him. Sadly, no Ring of Ginny summoning this time. Who are you? Ordinary Doppelganger, no problem. Ordinary Mimic, no problem either. That's another pool? Do we want to drink from that pool? What do you guys think? Do we want to drink from pool? No, I don't think we want. Rapier of Penetration? Maybe. We will find out before the end of this episode. I don't think we want any more pool sipping. What could we get from it? Your uncursed battle axe is torn apart. I don't mind. Let it be torn apart. No more pools. I think so too, nice. Like, you are right. We've got a couple pretty nice intrinsics. We could get a wish, but we already have a wish with our Ring of Ginny summoning. And we could get intrinsic invisibility, but we've got two rings of invisibility, so we don't really need that either. Shadowworm. Let's kill this giant first and now see if we can dragon slay the Shadowworm. Two hits and down it goes. Excellent. Take the quarterstaff, dragon slayer, and the gold. It's hard to play the game without any abuse of ranged weapons. And even if we just get it to level 4, we will soon get it to level 4. That's already worth quite a lot, I think. I will use the bow for a little while, just so we get to level 4. Come on. Yes! Bow's level 4. Takes 500 marks to get it to level 5, but level 4 is already rather decent. That's not bad. We've got a good bow. We've got a chance to hit these enemies. So, and down to the next level. I think level 4 should be fine. It will take ages until we get to level 5. So I don't want to really grind the bow skill up. Corrin, you've got a caster with poison hands. No ways of corruption removal. Multiple spellbooks in backpack. No thick gauntlets. Well, I don't think poison hand destroys the spellbooks, does it? It just affects potions, as far as I know. Or am I wrong? There's a tension room on this level. Let's keep an eye open for that. Next level is danger level 34. That's a lot, Nisek. So let's be prepared for... Okay, for Atins. Atins are no problem. Let's be prepared to face tough monsters. That was a hit. We will soon level up again. Not much missing. And these tension rooms always have a very high experience density. That's what I like about them. Water and gold. Quarter stuff, hill giant corpse. Let's eat the giant. It's an ordinary quarter stuff, not interested. There's not much missing till we level up again. It's the antediluvian dungeon, is it that? The one we're currently in? I always remember, forget these names. Little damage from this. From this vortex, but not too much. Our resistances seem to be fine. I think we're done with this level. Almost. A thin dagger, this is a throwing dagger, I think. Thin dagger, 10 stones. No need to pick that up. And we're done with this level. Getting deeper and deeper into this dungeon. Wait, there are no more downstairs? Are we at the bottom? Guys, I think we did it. I think we just finished this dungeon. Hell yeah, guys. And that was a successful dungeon. Ah, come on, get out of my way. We got a wish. So, that's the mission for all of us for the next episode. Let's think what we want to wish for. I tend towards 7-league boots, but maybe somebody has a even better idea. Sadly, you cannot wish for artifact weapons. We are almost leveled up. I hope we will find a couple more monsters on the way. So we can make it to level 27. Well, otherwise we'll get there very soon in the next episode. A current Girdle of Giant Strength also greatly increases the damage output. That's what I thought of. We are doing most of our fighting in melee. We cannot wish for a great weapon, so the best way to increase our damage output would be to wish for Girdle of Giant Strength. 27, level up. Here we got it. Let's get our climbing a tiny bit higher. And the rest on swimming. We want to become a decent swimmer. We get another talent too. I think we already have maxed out our carrying capacity. More experience gains to level up a little faster. Faster healing. Or should we maybe go for the shooting talents just so we have a bit better use of our bow? Almost considering that. Defensive talents, never a waste either. But I almost tend towards good shot. Experience talents is maybe a good idea. Yeah, nice, let's do that. Let's take good learner so we level up a little bit quicker from now on. We want to get to these max levels relatively fast. I'm not sure if I ever took the talent. I definitely never got this combination of talents on any past character. How many more talents will we get? Probably enough. Yeah, Nysik, you're right. You can only wish for one Girdle of Giant Strength. There is no way to wish for several. You can wish for pairs of 7-league boots, though. And I think that's what we might actually do in the next episode. But well, before we do that, let's quickly read the Scroll of Identify and check our loot of this episode. Just see if there is anything super great that we didn't realize we got. No gauntlets. These adamantium boots are pretty great. +4, +3. Let's uncurse all our items. Do we have a blessed scroll of uncursing? Do not. Let's create one. Scroll of uncursing into holy water. Read one of them. And swap our boots for these much better adamantium boots. What else do we have? Amulets. Is there anything nice here? Use the cornucopia for water. Yeah, we should do that. We still got an amulet of life saving, just in case we need it. Dwarven pickaxe hammerhead. We have here the spiked mace, transmogrifier. The spiked mace, Michael's transmogrifier. It is a mace, and we are training clubs. Is clubs and maces the same talent? Nope, it's not. Clubs and hammers. If it was, damn. It would have been worth otherwise, but from level zero, I don't think that's worth. I'd still like to know what exactly it does. Let's read a scroll of great identify on this spiked mace transmogrifier. Charisma, it spreads terror and shock resistance that actually sucks pretty hard. What a crappy weapon. What else do we have here? Any amazing one-handed weapons? Balance Warhammer? Nope, 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 nope. That all looks pretty unspectacular. Turnium two-handed sword. A worm lance is great, but we cannot, don't want to use two-handed weapons. Stuff of sensing traps is actually pretty nice. We've got a blessed ring of ice. We might need that soon. We've got the ring of Ginny summoning. That was the highlight of this episode. That was really good. Corin, have a nice evening too. 4 a.m. already. Corin, we will finish this episode in just a second, so you will not miss anything. Got a 500 stone, terrible higher metal mace. Oh yeah, we better drop that soon. We have got the teleportation wand. Apart from that, wand of earthquakes. No really great wands. What here about the potions? Let's take a close look at these. Why didn't we bless these water potions? We better drink raw mana and troll blood. No, no great potions either. Scrolls. Defense is the only one that I really like. We will use that on our Red Dragon Scale armor. And I guess that is it. Yeah, that's it. Let's just drop this horrible 500 stone mace that I was just told about. Where is it? Where is that horrible mace? Extra heavy blah blah mace. Yeah, drop this. Ultra heavy mithril broadsword. And let's eat this large ration. Let's drink potential learning, troll blood, raw mana, and raw mana. And I think, let's bless the scroll of defense. And use it on our Red Dragon Scale armor. Glows in blue light. Now it is a plus 5 defense. Red Dragon Scale armor. That's so good. Plus 5 plus 15. Holy moly. Keep using the braces of toughness and the ordinary gauntlets. The blessed archery gauntlets are actually pretty good. The archery gloves. Yeah, that was a really lucky roll on defense indeed. Let's also use these great boots. And that's our character for now. Guys, and this is where we end this episode. I think we can be pretty happy with our progress, especially this Ring of Genie summoning is amazing. So, mission for all of us. Think about what we want to use this wish on. If you got a great idea, write it on the Discord, or you might as well just say it in the next stream. Next stream will be... I cannot promise another stream for this week. On Thursday, we will rehearse with the band, so I don't get a Thursday stream done this week. Friday and Saturday, I will be at a great party. It's going to be totally amazing with friends from England, Italy, Norway, and Belgium coming. It's going to be a fantastic party, but I will not be able to stream on these days either, and there is a decent chance I will have a terrible hangover on Sunday, so I'm not sure if I will be able to stream on Sunday. Probably not. So I think this will be the only stream for this week, I'm afraid. But we will definitely continue with Spartacus Adventures on next Tuesday, same time as today. So if you've got nothing on your plan for next Tuesday, I would be very, very lucky, very, very happy if you tuned in again to cheer for Spartacus. Until then, let me say big thanks to everybody who tuned in today and who crossed his or her fingers for Spartacus. I think it was totally fun with you guys, as always. Big thanks to everyone who will see this episode later on YouTube. One more time, next stream, next week, Tuesday, roughly 8:30 p.m. Until then, bye everybody.